Welcome my dear students, today we are going to start another application which is reliability design under dynamic programming. So in today's lecture I am going to cover what is meant by reliability design, and also we will see an example, and also we will see how to solve that example. Now coming to the objective, with today's lecture the students are able to understand the concept of reliability design and coming to the outcome. Now after learning this lecture, the students are able to apply the reliability design concept on a given circuit. What is meant by reliability design? Now here when you are developing an electronic circuits, so here you'll be having several devices in a circuit, am I right or not? So here let us consider one of the concept under that. So here the problem is to design a system that has several devices connected in series, so like this. So here I'll be having dn devices from d1 to dn, okay. So all these devices are connected in series. So when these are connected in series, now I'll be having the reliability of each device. Let us consider the reliability of each device is ri. Ri is a reliability of each device, that is reliability of device di. Now the overall reliability of the system when the devices are connected in series can be given as pi ri. So for suppose let us consider I'll be having 10 devices, that is n is equal to 10. I'll be having n 10 devices. Now if I want the reliability of the entire system, so and individual reliability of each device is 0.99. Let us consider here the reliability of an individual device is 0.99 and I'll be having 10 devices. So now if I want to find the reliability of the entire system will be given as pi ri, right? So 0.99 into 0.99, right? So likewise I need to multiply, right? So for 10 types, that can be given as 0.99 whole to the power of 10, right? So this will be equivalent to 0.902, right? So now if you have seen clearly, the reliability of individual devices is very high, but if I am connecting them in parallel, the total system reliability is getting decreased, am I right or not? Although the each and individual device reliability is high, but whenever they are connected in series, the total reliability of the system gets degraded, right? So this is a main drawback when I am connected all these devices in series, right? So now in order to overcome this problem, I am having the solution like this. That is, here I'm going to connect all these devices in parallel with the help of, okay, here I'm going to have the circuit like this. That is, here I'll be having some number of copies of the same device. That is, let us consider here D1 as a stage 1. So here I'll be having multiple copies. Here 3 copies of device D1 and 2 copies of device D2. Likewise, I'll be having some number of copies of each device I'm connecting in parallel, okay, with the help of switching circuits. So then I'll be having the overall reliability of the system. Now there will not be any decrease, such that I'll be having the reliability of the entire system will be high compared to the previous one. Now we will see in detail. So here let ri be the reliability of device di. Now the reliability of entire system, the reliability of entire system is pi ri. Now coming to, even if the individual device is having a high reliability, the entire system reliability gets decreased. For example, here if n is equal to 10 and ri is equal to 0.99, now pi ri is equal to 0.904. so here the individual reliability is 0.99, but the overall reliability of the system is degraded to 0.904, so which means that the reliability is decreased, right? So in order to overcome this problem, I'm having one more solution. That is,
here duplication of devices at each stage. For example, here I'm showing the solution, multiple copies of same device, multiple copies of same device I'm going to take at each and every stage, and then those devices are connected in parallel with the help of switching circuit. For example, here stage 1, here I'm having stage 1, stage 1 consisting of 3 devices, that is nothing but 3 copies of same device called D1, and stage 2 consisting of 2 copies of device D2, and stage 3 consisting of 3 copies of same device which is D3, and all these are connected in parallel with the help of switching circuits. With the help of switching circuits we are going to connect all these circuits or all these devices. Now here at each and every stage I am making some copies of same device, right? So that notation I am taking it as a MI. MI number of copies I am going to have at each and every stage. For example, here I have taken three copies of same device called D1. So now here the M1 value will be equal to 3. Why? Because 3 copies at this stage, and here 2 copies of device D2, and here M3 will be equal to 3 copies of device D3. So likewise I'll be having MI number of copies at each and every stage. 1 minus RI whole to the power of MI is a probability of the probability of the device functions properly without having any malfunction. So here RI is a reliability of each and every device, right? MI is a number of copies at each stage. So here 1 minus RI whole to the power of MI, since the probability, the maximum probability is 1. The maximum probability is 1. So here I am taking that without having any malfunction, the corresponding device probability, the corresponding device probability without having any malfunction is given as 1 minus RI whole to the power of MI. Now here whenever I'm talking about the entire system, here I'll be using even the switching circuits to connect each and every stage. Am I right or not? So here even there will be some defect, right? There will be some defect even for switching circuits also in some cases. So the overall system reliability will be given as 1 minus RI whole to the power of MI. So here this 1 minus RI whole to the power of MI is a probability of the device which works properly without having any malfunction at each stage, right? Whereas the probability of entire stage or at each stage is given as 1 minus RI whole to the power of MI. Why here 1 minus? Because here even the switching circuits can also have some defects, right? Because the switching circuits are also manufactured by human people, so there might be some defects. So in order to omit those defects, here I am giving 1 minus. Okay, the overall stage probability is 1 minus RI whole to the power of MI, right? That I am going to represent with a variable called phi i of MI, which is equal to 1 minus RI whole to the power of MI, right? Now, basically what we are performing over here, we are taking the multiple copies of same device at each and every stage. Am I right or not? So for that, here the problem, in this problem we need to use device duplicates to maximize the probability. The main theme is to have the maximum probability. Here the main theme of the entire system reliability should be high. The entire system reliability should be high. Then only I can say that my circuit works properly and is having some lifetime. Whenever the reliability is more, its lifetime will be more. So now that's the reason our main theme of this particular problem or the application is to achieve maximum reliability for the entire system. So this can be represented mathematically as maximize pi of phi i of MI. Here the phi i of MI is represented as 1 minus 1 minus Ri whole to the power of mi, and where I lies in between 1 and n. Why? Because here I'll be having divisors from d1 to dn. So d1 to dn. So that's the reason I lies in between 1 and 10. And 1 and n are inclusive and subjected to the constraint called Ci mi is less than or equal to c. C is the maximum allowable cost. C is the maximum allowable cost, and Ci is the individual cost of each device for manufacturing, and mi is the maximum allowable number of copies at each stage. Now here the mi is greater than or equal to 1, and n and I is in between 1 and n. Now where Ci is the cost of each device, Ci is the cost of each device, and C is the maximum allowable cost, and mi is the copies of each device at each stage. Now here the upper bound. Upper bound means the maximum allowable number of copies at each stage. Maximum allowable copies at each stage is given with the upper bound. What is the upper bound value? Ui. Ui stands for maximum allowable copies at each stage. Maximum allowable copies at each stage is given as Ui, and that Ui can be found with the formula called C plus Ci minus summation Cj whole by Ci. So here summation Cj is nothing but the cost of all the devices, sum of the cost of all the devices. So C means the maximum allowable cost, and plus Ci minus summation Cj whole by Ci. This will yield us upper bound. Upper bound is nothing but here U, which is a maximum allowable copies at each stage of this device Di. Coming to this, now we are going to find out our solution with the help of dynamic programming, right? So in your dynamic programming, here it should satisfy the principle of optimality, and also we are representing our solution with the help of a recurrence relation. So here the recurrence relation I'm going to use fi of x. So in order to measure this fi of x, so here we need to find out some sets. Here like your knapsack problem, here also we need to generate some sets. So the sets are Si. Okay, here we need to generate some sets, and in each set I'll be having the values called f comma x. So here in each set I'll be having tuples like this, and f depicts reliability and x depicts cost. Okay, here f comma x, and here f represents reliability and x represents cost. And fi of x is equal to maximum of phi I of mi into fi minus 1 of x minus ci mi. So by means of this recurrence relation I am going to find out. So here if you have seen clearly, fi of x minus ci mi into phi i of mi. So here I am going to multiply the reliability. Please remember, reliability is multiplied and the cost should be added for generating the next set. Now coming to initial or base condition, that is f0 of x is equal to 1, which means that I am considering the highest reliability, that is 1. The maximum reliability is 1 only, right? So now initially I am taking f0 of x is equal to 1 for all x, and 0 is less than, x is less than or equal to c. Now coming to the dominance rule. Dominance rule or purging rule. Here whenever I am having two tuples f1, x1 and f2, x2. Here I will be having two tuples. So here I have to eliminate a tuple where I am having the less reliability and more cost, which is having the less reliability. For suppose here f1 is less than f2 and x1 is greater than x2. So here I am having a condition called the reliability is less and cost is more. So in that case I have to remove the f1 comma x1 pair. Pair has to be removed. Understood? So here if there are two pairs under purging rule or dominance rule, f1 comma x1, f2 comma x2. So in this case, the pair which is having less reliability and more cost, so that pair has to be removed. Okay? So that is our dominance rule. Let us consider an example where the maximum cost is C is equal to 105, and this is a cost of each and every device and also reliability of each and every device is also given to you, right? Now we need to calculate the upper bound. Upper bound formula is UI is equal to C plus CI minus, right, summation CJ by CI. So initially upper bound, why I need to calculate the upper bound? Because I need to know the maximum allowable number of copies. Basing on that only I have to generate the corresponding sets. So now U1, what is the U1 value? U1 is equal to C plus, what is the C value? 105 plus CI. CI stands for C1. What is the cost of first device? 30 minus summation CJ, which is nothing but 30 plus 15 plus 20. Okay. Whole by CI. What is the CI value? 30. Right? So now, which is equal to 105 plus 30 minus 30 plus 15 plus 20, which is 50 plus 15, 65, right? 65 whole by 30, right? So which is equal to 135 minus 65, which is equal to 70, right? So 70 by 30, so which is equal to 2.4, right? So which is approximately equal to 2, right? So now U1 is equal to 2. In the same manner, I need to find out U2. So now we'll see how to compute this upper bound. U1 is equal to 105 plus 30 minus all the cost, 30 plus 15 plus 20 by 30, which is equal to 2.33 approximately, which is equal to 2. Now corresponding to U2 means the maximum allowable copies in stage 2, which is equal to 105 plus 15 minus all these costs by 15, which is equal to 3. Now U3 is equal to 3. In the same fashion, we are going to find out U3 also, which is equal to 105 plus 20 minus 30 plus 15 plus 20 by 20, which is equal to 3. So now, what is our next step? We need to compute S-size. So to measure this S-size, we need to compute S-I-J's, right? So basing on these upper bound values, I need to compute at each and every stage. So here U1 is equal to 2. What it means? It means that M1 is equal to 1 or 2. Maximum allowable number of copies is 1 or 2, right? And here the maximum allowable copies is 3. And here the maximum allowable copies in this stage is 3. So now coming to this, therefore U1, U2, U3 is equal to 2, 3, 3. Now initially what I need to compute? S0 and S1. Here please remember your sets consisting of tuples in the form of F, X, where F stands for reliability and X stands for cost. Now initially we need to compute S-i's for computation of S-i's, as I mentioned earlier. Now initially S0 is equal to 1, 0. As I said, initially F0 of X is given as 1, because I am taking the highest reliability. What is the highest reliability? 1. So 1, 0, the cost is 0. And from this I am going to derive the remaining values. So now S0 is equal to 1, 0. Now I need to compute S1. So in order to measure S1, I have to find out S11 and S12. Why only two values? Because U1 is equal to 2. Since U1 is equal to 2, the maximum allowable copies are 2. So now S11 and S12 I need to measure. For example, here U1 is equal to 3 means I need to measure S11, S12 and S13 also. So basing on this upper bound value, I need to find the corresponding values. Okay, so now S11, what is meant by S11? So now S11 means here I is equal to 1 and J is equal to 1 and MI is equal to J, which is equal to 1. MI is equal to J, which is equal to 1. So M1 is equal to 1 over here in the first case, right? So here basing on that, here I can say that S11 means here we have used one copy of device D1. S11 stands for
one copy of device D1 is used. S12 stands for
two copies of device D1 is used. Now let us find out the values. So initially 5i of mi can be given as 5i of m1, which is equal to 1 minus 1 minus r1 whole to the power of m1. So r1, reliability of device D1 is 0.9. So 1 minus 1 minus 0.9, which is equal to 0.9. Now as we found 5i of mi, what is our next step? I need to find out the cost associated with that. So CIMI. So now cost of the first device and here m1, right? So here cost of first device. What is the cost of first device? Which is 30. And since we are taking one copy, here S11 stands for, we are taking one copy of device D1. So M1 is equal to 1, which is equal to 30. So now the reliability is 0.9 and the cost is 30. So now S11 will be equivalent to 0.9, CIMI, right? CIMI is equal to C1 M1. So which is equal to cost of first device is 30 into, since we are using one copy of device D1 to measure S11. So here 30 into 1, which is equal to 30. So now S11 can be measured as F comma X. F is your 0.9 comma cost is 30. So 0.9 comma 30, and to measure S12 means here I'm having two copies of device D1. So see here I value is 1, J value is 2, and M1 is equal to 2, because which is equal to J, right? So which is equal to, so here I have used two copies of device D1. So here also I need to find out 5i of mi. So now what is the 5i of mi value? 1 minus 1 minus ri. Ri means r1. R1 value is 0.9 whole to the power of mi. Here the mi value is 2. So now 1 minus 1 minus 0.9 means 0.1 whole square, right? So which is equal to 1 minus 0.01. So which will be equal to 0.99. Which will be equal to 0.99. And coming to this C1 M1. So here I'm taking two copies of device D1. So what is the cost of device D1? 30 into 2, which is equal to 60. So now what is the corresponding value of S12? Now S12 is equal to 0.99, 60. Understood? So here S11 is equal to 0.9, 30, and S12 is equal to 0.99, 60. So here at each and every stage we need to calculate the corresponding sets, and initially S0 is equal to 1, 0, since we have taken the highest reliability and the cost is, we have assumed as 0. That is the initial condition. Now coming to generate S1, we need to find out S11 and S12. Why? Because the upper bound is U1 is equal to 2. Since U1 is equal to 2, the maximum allowable copies are 2. So S11 and S12. So to measure S11, here 5i of mi is equal to 1 minus 1 minus r1 whole to the power of m1, which is equal to 0.9. And CIMI, which is C1 m1, which is equal to 30 into 1, which is equal to 30. And coming to S11, S11 can be measured as 0.9, 30, because F, X, reliability, cost. And here S12 means I is equal to 1, J is equal to 2, and M1 is equal to 2, because here we have used two copies of device D1. Now 5i of mi is equal to 1 minus 1 minus 0.9 whole to the power of 2, which is equal to 0.99. And coming to the cost, cost is C1 M1. What is the cost of device D1? 30. So 30 into, here we are using two copies. So 30 into 2, which is equal to 60. So together the corresponding pair for S12 is 0.99, 60. Now S1 can be found by merging S11 and S12. So that will be, by merging these two, I'll be getting S1 as 0.9, 30, 0.99, 60. Now let's see once again the same thing, which is C1 M1 is equal to 30 into 1, which is equal to 30, and S11 is equal to 0.9 comma 30, and S12, here S12 means we have used two copies of device D1. Now phi I of MI, again I am going to find out, which is equal to 0.99, and C1 M1 which is equal to 60. So now S12 we have 0.99 comma 60. Now to measure S1 we need to merge both these, okay, both of these. So when merging, this is the final output, that is 0.9 comma 30, 0.99 comma 60. Now let's have our next one, which is compute S2. To measure S2 I need to find out S21, S22, S23. Why? Because since U2 is equal to 3, the maximum allowable copies are 3. So that's the reason I need to measure S21, S22 and S23. So now S21. So S21. S21 means I is equal to 2, J is equal to 1 and M2 is equal to 1. Why? Because M2 is equal to J. Now again I need to find out phi I of MI, which is equal to 1 minus ri whole to the power of mi. So which is equal to 1 minus ri. Ri means R2. The reliability of second device is 0.8. Whole to the power of mi. Whole to the power of mi. Mi value is 1. So which is equal to 1 minus 0.2. Right. So which is equal to 0.8. Right. Now CIMI. So here the cost of second device, the cost of second device is 15 into one copy I am using, so 1, right, 15. So together the S21 will be equivalent to 0.8 comma 15, right, sorry. Here I have phi I of MI is equal to 0.2, right, whereas CIMI is equal to CIMI, which is nothing but 15 into 1, which is equal to 15, right. So here I have the reliability and cost. So here for measuring this S12, I need to take the base as S1. I need to take the base value as S1. So by taking S1 as a base, I need to find out this S12. So how to measure that? That is here, the reliability is multiplied and the cost should be added. So here 0.9 into this 0.2 we need to do, and also this 30 should be added to this 15. So likewise I'll be having the pairs in S12. So now S12, here phi I of MI is equal to 0.8, as you have seen. Now C2 M2 is equal to 15, right. So now S12, what is the S12 value? Here I have S1 values as 0.9 comma 30 and 0.99 comma 60, right. So here 0.9 has to be multiplied with this 0.8. So now 0.9 into 0.8 comma 30 plus 15, and here 0.99 into 0.8 comma 60 plus 15. So together it is yielding me 0.72 comma 45 comma 0.792 comma 75. Please remember, here the reliability should be multiplied and the cost should be added. Reliability should be multiplied and the cost should be added. Now coming to the next pair, which is S22. S22 means the maximum allowable copies are 2, right. So M2 is equal to 2, I is equal to 2 and J is equal to 2. So phi I, corresponding phi I we are going to measure with as 0.96. Now C2 M2 is equal to 30, right. So now here if I want to measure S22, so now what is S22? So here again I have to take the base as S1 only, please remember. So now 0.9 into here, what is the value, corresponding value, reliability 0.96 comma here 30 plus, what is the cost I have, 30 comma here I will be having 0.99. So 0.99 into 0.96 comma here I have 60. So 60 plus 30, right. So together which will be equal to 0.864 comma 60 comma 0.95 comma 90, okay. So likewise I need to measure, that is the reliability should be multiplied. And please remember, whenever I am generating sets, the previous set should be the base to measure the corresponding set. And to measure the current iteration set, I have to multiply the reliability and the cost should be added. This is how I need to measure S22. Now again for S23, again I have to take MI value as 3. Why? Because here the two copies of device the three copies of device D2 are used. Since M2 is equal to 3, three copies of device D2 are used.
Now, corresponding phi I value is 0.992 and CIMI value is 45. Now again, take S1 as a base and multiply the corresponding reliability and add the corresponding cost. So together I will be having these three values. So now what is the next step? I need to measure S2, right? So to measure S2, here I will be having three values, right? So here 45, 75, 60, 90, 75 and 105. So what is the maximum reliability? Maximum reliability is 105, right? So here I'm having two pairs with 75, that is 0.792 and 0.898 75. So what is our main theme? The main theme is the overall reliability of the system must be high. So whichever is a pair is having the low reliability, that lowest reliability pair should be removed. So now out of these two, remove the pair with low reliability. What is the reliability pair? First pair is a low reliability pair. So remove this pair and finally I will be having 5 values, right? Out of these 5 values, again here I am showing you only 4. Why? Because now 45, 60, 90, 75 and 105. So this is our order, right? So here order of costs is 45, 60, since we have removed this, right? We removed this 60, 90 and 75 and 105. So here please remember one more point. Here all the costs of all the pairs should be in ascending order. So while measuring the sets, here all the pairs should be in the ascending order. Their cost should be in the ascending order. So here 45, 60, 90. So here it is disobeying the rule. So since it is disobeying the rule, here 90 should be removed. So the pair which is having 90 should also be removed. So the remaining 4 pairs we have written over here. So this is the final S2. Now in the same fashion I need to find out S3 also. So S3 can be measured by merging S13, by measuring S31, S32 and S33. Why? Because here U3 is equal to 3. So here also I will be having 3 values. So now here since the 90 is less than 75 condition failed, as I said all these should be in the ascending order. So that's the reason here we have removed even this pair with 90 as a cost. Now the next step is to compute S3. To compute S3 we need to measure S31, S32 and S33. So now to measure S31, I is equal to 3 and J is equal to 1 and M3 is equal to 1. Now again I need to find out phi I of mi over here, which is equal to 1 minus ri whole to the 1 minus ri whole to the power of mi. So here ri is 0.5. So if I am substituting over here, I will be having phi I of mi is 0.5 and C3 M3 is equal to 20. So now S13 is equal to, so to measure this S31, here I have to take this as a base, S2 as a base. So as I already said, here the reliability should be multiplied and the cost should be added. So 0.72 into 0.5 comma 45 plus 20. Likewise here I have written all these pairs. And here since the cost exceeds 105, because here 105 plus the corresponding 20, our last pair will be having some reliability followed by 105 plus 20, right, which is equal to 125. But the maximum cost which is given as 105, right? So maximum allowable cost is 105. So as it exceeds 105, I am removing the last pair. So that's the reason I will be having only 3 pairs, right? Now in the same fashion I am going to find out even S32. So for S32 the maximum allowable copies of device D3 is 2. So now again C3 M3 is 40 and phi I of MI is 75. Now in the same fashion for S23, for measuring S32 here the base is S2. So again here also the reliability should be multiplied and the cost should be added, which is 0.72 into this 0.75 and 45 plus 40 and 0.86 into 0.75, 60 plus 40. Likewise, we are doing it. So finally, here I am having only 2 pairs because here 105 plus 40. So here I will be having 145 as a cost. And here I will be having 75 plus 40.
here I'll be having 115 as a cost, right? So since these two pairs are having maximum cost, okay, greater than 105, I'm removing these two pairs. Finally, I'll be having only two pairs in this. So S32 is the final answer. For S32, these two are the pairs. In the same fashion, I need to measure S33 also. To measure S33, again I need to find out 53 of M3 and C3 M3. Okay, let's see that. So now to measure S33, again C3 M3 and 53 of M3. So now S33, again take the base as S2 and multiply the reliability and add the cost. So finally we'll be having 0.72 into 0.875, 45 plus 60. So likewise I'm having four pairs, right? Out of this I'll be having 60 plus 60, which is 120. So I'm going to remove this pair, and even 105 plus 60, 165, which is also greater than 105, I'll remove the pair. And 60 plus 75, this is also exceeding 105, so I'll remove the pair. So finally I'll be having only one pair under S33, which is 0.63, 105. So now the next thing, S3 is to merge the remaining three, which is S3, S3, S32, S33. If I am merging all these three, I'll be getting S3. So whenever merging, I need to check for the dominance rule. So here I'll be having 0.5485, and okay, so here let us consider these two, right? 0.4464, 95, 0.54, 85. So here I'll be having two, okay, here as I'm having these two pairs. So F1 is, since F1 is less than F2 and X1 is greater than X2, please see here, the reliability is low and the cost is high. So I need to remove this pair, that is F1, X1, which is 0.44, 64, 95 should be removed. Why? Because here the next pair is having the high reliability and low cost. So I will keep that and I will remove the current pair. So now finally, even this 0.63, 105 is also removed. Why? Because it has low reliability than the previous. So here, if you have seen here, 0.63, 105 and 0.648, 100. So here the reliability is more compared to this, whereas the cost is high, right? Even for these two pairs also. So even this also to be removed. So finally, I am going to remove this and remove this, right? So finally, I'll be having S3 with these four pairs. Please remember, S3 with these four pairs. The next step is to trace a solution, right? So here we are going to find out our solution like this. That is, how many number of copies of device at each and every stage I have to use? That is, M1 is equal to how many, M2 is equal to how many, and M3 is equal to how many, right? So this is what I need to find out. So basing on, okay, this is our final solution, right? So now to measure that here, okay. So now initially, what is the highest reliability pair? 0.648, 100 is the highest reliability pair which occurred in the S3. So since 0.648, 100 is a high reliability pair, and which actually firstly occurs in S23, which is 0.648, 100, which belongs to S32. So therefore I can say that M3 is equal to 2. S32 means M3 is equal to 2. So now the next thing is to measure from where this 0.648, 100 appears. So the 0.648, 100 appears from this pair. Which pair? 0.864, 60. That 0.864, 60 is appeared in S22. So now, as this is belongs to S22, then maximum number of copies of device D2 is 2. Now again we need to trace back from where this 0.864, 60 appears. This 0.864, 60 comes from 0.9, 30, and this 0.9, 30 initially I have it S11. So now M1 is equal to 1. So finally, what is my solution now? M1 is equal to 1, M2 is equal to 2, and M3 is equal to 2. If I am using one copy of device D1, two copies of device D2, and three copies of device D3, I will be having maximum reliability. What is that maximum reliability of the overall circuit? 0.648. Okay, now coming to the summary. Now, today we have seen what is meant by reliability design for a given circuit, and also we have seen, okay, how to measure the reliability of the entire system, as we are having some drawbacks, okay, as we are having some drawbacks when all these devices are connected in series. That is the reason we are taking the devices, we are connecting all these devices in parallel by taking multiple copies of the same device at each stage, and we are connecting all these stages with the help of switching circuits, right? So now overall theme is to have the maximum reliability, okay? Overall theme is to occur the maximum reliability for the entire circuit, okay? For that I am making duplication of devices at each and every stage. So how many number of duplicates I have to make is our problem statement now. And also we have seen one of the example also, right? And coming to the assignment, so here as you don't have the algorithm in your textbook, so try to implement the algorithm like your DNAP. DNAP is nothing but dynamic knapsack problem, right? So in the same fashion you try to implement the algorithm for the reliability design. So in your DNAP they have developed the algorithm basing on the given recurrence relation. So here also I had mentioned you the recurrence relation and initial base conditions also. So basing on that try to implement the algorithm, right?